This is Dr. Mark. I'm up on the Mount Ashland PCT with Siskiyou Peak behind me. And I want to talk about what you need to do as a patient to get over a lumbar disc problem. Could be you have sciatica, could be you just have what we call an axial disc or a flexion intolerant low back. You may know what's going on. You have trouble sitting. You don't like bending over. You don't like picking up stuff from the floor. And you have pain. And what do you need to do? Number one, learn what to do differently. How to change how you tie your shoes. How to change how you get out of bed. How to change how you bend over the sink. Don't bend over the sink like this. Bend over the sink like this. You have to learn that waiter's bow. Learn that hip hinge. Learn that hip hinge. That's so critical. That's step one. You have to learn pain relief exercises, which could be McKendie extension or could be the various decompression exercises that we like to teach. Those are great things to learn. After all that, you need to know what exercises not to do. Don't bring your knee to your chest. Don't touch your toes. Don't do sun salutation. Don't do forward bending exercises. Any forward bending exercise, riding a stationary bike, unfortunately, is a forward bending exercise. You're sitting and trying to exercise. It's going to screw up your disc. We're all the way to number four. We're finally starting to talk about core strength, core stability, core endurance. It's number four on the list. It's none at the beginning. There's all kinds of details for each of these pieces that I'm not going to teach in this little YouTube. Number five, restore mobility to your hips if they're stuck, to whatever's stuck in your lumbar, and to your thoracolumbar. Exercise-wise, it's the thoracics get more mobility, the hips need to get more mobility. Your chiropractor or physical therapist may be able to help you with that. Again, it's number five. You want the mobility, but you start with quit hurting yourself. This is Dr. Mark, Mount Ashland. Take care.